Let me tell you this. Many top lawyers are afraid to say what I'm going to say. The Supreme Court today started during the late Katsina Alu to assume the duties of the Court of Appeal in looking into election petitions. The law before Katsina Alu's case, or before the Salami saga, was that gubernatorial elections will terminate at the Court of Appeal. Now, for one reason or the other, Salami's case crept up, and there was the rumor that he had received money, and there was a judgment, and Katsina Alu says that judgment must be stopped. And the man refused. History knows what happened. But what I'm going to tell you, at that stage, the Supreme Court decided to take over matters that were previously meant for the Court of Appeal. And the law was amended that now the Supreme Court can now handle matters relating to gubernatorial elections. But let me tell you this. In the good sense of those who made the law, there are 36 states in Nigeria. There are almost 40, divisions of the Court of Appeal. So if there are gubernatorial matters, maybe within 3 months, 4 months, the 36 petitions will have been answered. Now the Supreme Court is now taking upon itself to take 36 gubernatorial elections with a panel of three only. I listened to one of my young ones, who is a silk, saying that the Supreme Court in Nigeria today is the most overworked court in the whole world.
Is that true?
That is it. But this is a self-inflicted injury by themselves. Why should they take over jurisdiction of petitions on gubernatorial matters?
Does the Constitution spell it out that the Supreme Court does not have jurisdiction in those matters?
Look, what the law says was that elections to governorship positions after the tribunal goes to the Court of Appeal as a final court. And that has been what has been on 1999, 2003, 2007. However, because of this Salami saga, the Supreme Court decided to take over jurisdiction. Now, this question of corruption is the brainwork of politicians. I want anybody to challenge me here. Since this operation of the Constitution in 1999, the politicians have been corrupting all judges. Let me say this. I once had an opportunity. A governor was telling me that, oh, Chief Clerk, it is not how much we are going to pay you lawyers, but it is how much we are going to pay the judges. It's as bad as that.
So they pay judges.
I'm telling you, that was the statement made me. But let me tell you this. If you say there are no corruptions, then to those who don't know what is going on, it may go. But what the federal government has done now by showing out how much Onoga has in various accounts shows you where did he get all the money from? Where did he get it from? I have been practicing law for almost 50 years. I don't think I have up to $10,000 in my foreign account. These are five public officers who have not been working, they have not been doing private practice, more than earning salary. It's a good thing for this country.
So you agree with the federal government?
I agree with the federal government totally. What they cannot get from the tribunal, they are getting it from public opinion now.
You think the public is happy with the move that has been made?
It's not a public. We are bewildered. I'm telling you, we are all bewildered.
How do you think this will end? Because there's been, the High Court seems not to, twice now, said, hold on that case. There's been, and the way it's going, you think that the CCT, because there's been an argument over whether or not the public officer, the line between the public officer and the judicial officer, and the case of asset declaration, that thing, can
Let me tell you
shed
this.
Light on it.
There is a case which is the normal case now, where the Supreme Court, that panel was headed by the CJ himself, okay, says that for matters pertaining to the code of conduct, the code of conduct tribunal is the highest court for that matter. So why should you run to the high court to get an injunction?
Okay. Chief Clerk, I'd like to pause you for a moment. We'll take another break. But before we go on that break, let me show you, did you see that segment? To just draw your attention to it, I'm very sure that a lot of you watched it. It's a case of a shy candidates, debate candidates. All right, let's go on the break. When we come back, I will show you that. We look at the implication of the move against the CJN and the 2019 election. Also, the question is INEC at a crossroads?